Hi everybody, I am Matt Flagg. I'm the Senior Wellness Director at the Fort Meigs YMCA. Today we're going to be bringing you a little bit something different, something for maybe some of you athletes out there who are kind of missing practices, missing time in the weight room right now, missing kind of some speed and agility work, kind of looking to supplement that. This is definitely something for you today. So we're going to do a little bit of a dynamic warm-up, and then we're going to get into some drills that will kind of help you with your speed and agility for all sports, for lacrosse, for field hockey, baseball, football, anything that you might be coming up looking forward to for the next school year. All of these drills will definitely help. Parents, I encourage you also, if you want to kind of participate, this will be something too that you can also do as a family, as a group. At the end, we'll be doing a drill where we might need a little bit of help anyways. So let's get started with our dynamic warm-up. The first thing we're going to do, dynamic warm-ups are great for speed and agility training as opposed to more static stretching. We can do static stretching at the end to get our muscles warmed up for kind of the activities that we're going to be doing today. It's very important that we do a dynamic warm-up. We're going to be doing a lot of skips just so that we kind of get our muscles ready for the movements that we're going to be going through in a little bit later. So the first one that we're going to do, pretty standard, it's an A skip. So we're going to skip down using our arms. Making sure we're using our arms coming all the way through. When we're going through these movements too, we want to make sure that we're keeping nice posture. We're using our arms. Obviously, when we're running or doing anything with speed, we want to make sure we're using our arms. We're not going to run like this. So we want to make sure that we're using our arms all the way through, driving up, staying on our toes, making sure our foot's kind of dorsiflexed. So that means it's kind of pointed up to this, up to the ceiling. We don't want our toe pointing down. If our toe points down, it has to correct itself before we get to that next movement, which will help you. It can cost a couple of tenths of a second trying to make that adjustment. That could be the difference between getting thrown out at first base or getting safe at first base. So make sure your toes are pointed up to the ceiling. We're gonna do that one more time. A skip going back. Again, toe pointing up, pumping those arms, and we're gonna relax. So we'll do that down and back. I probably have this set up just so that you can see me in frame for a couple of yards. If you're outside, if you have a larger basement, this is something where you can do kind of the length of that and back. But again, this is just kind of a nice demonstration to get us warmed up. Next one, going to be a B skip. So we're going to keep that A movement, then we're going to kick our foot out and kind of paw it down to the ground and come back up. So it's going to look a little something like this. It's going to be A. Again, making sure we're using our arms. Don't be stationary. Make sure you're pumping your arms. We're going to do that same thing going back. Nice B skip. Get up to the A. Kick out. Straight down. Drive that foot down towards the ground. Kind of get our hips warmed up. I'm going to do a C skip. So it's going to kind of be an up and out. So we're going to, again, arm down and then kind of off to the side. So this one might take you a little bit of time to get used to. It's a little awkward at first. So it's going to be out, up. We'll go right foot all the way down. Then we'll kind of do that same thing going back with the left. Down and out. Really making sure we're opening up that hip, getting everything nice and warmed up through that hip area there. Next, do some knee hugs. Just going to take this, hug it to our chest. Take our leg, hug it up to the chest, kind of get up on that toe. Nice, easy movement there. That same thing going back. Up to your chest, up to your toe. And we'll relax. One more, and then we'll kind of keep going through some drills. We're going to do some mummy walks. We're going to keep our hands straight out in front. We're going to kick our leg out. And kind of just keep on walking down, trying to kick our toe up to our hands. Then we'll go back one more time the other direction. Try a couple more here. And we'll relax. So now we're pretty warmed up. That's a nice little simple drills that we can do to get warmed up. You can use those obviously before practices, before games. That just a little quick 3-5 minute warm up, making sure that our blood's getting to the muscles that we're about to use. So next, we're going to set up a couple of drills that we can run through to kind of help you with your speed and agility. All right, now that we're all nice and warmed up, we got the blood going to the muscles we're about to work, we're going to do a couple of exercises here that are going to help with our speed and agility. As you can see, I have a chair. This could be a chair at home, it could be your couch, it could be a basement step, it could be anything that's gonna kinda get one leg elevated up off the ground. We don't want it too much higher than this chair though, so whatever you can kinda find, just make sure you're kind of a couple of foot, like a foot, foot and a half off of the ground. The first movement we're gonna do is kind of a split-legged squat jump. We're gonna do 10 of these each leg. So we're gonna kinda hop out, make sure that when we're squatting down that our knee doesn't get up over our toe, and then we're gonna explode with this leg that's on the ground up off the ground. So we're gonna go one, two, like that, then we'll switch. Right after that, with no rest at all, we're gonna go right to the wall. So make sure you're kinda close to a wall. We're gonna kinda do a wall drill here. It's kinda like a wall push. We're gonna try this four times, anywhere between 10 and 15 seconds a piece. So we're gonna start with one leg up. We're gonna keep a nice 45 degree angle here, nice flat back. Start with one leg up, and then we're gonna drop our knees as quickly as we can, staying on our toes, and then we'll take a break after that. So we'll kinda go ahead and make sure this chair's not gonna go anywhere. I'm gonna start with my left foot on the ground. I'm gonna hop out, we're gonna try 10 of these. There's our halfway, there's five. Really get nice and deep. Two to go. And our last one, 10, we'll shake that off. Put our left leg up on the chair. Maybe. Find where the chair is. Same thing, nice deep squat. Coming up off the ground. Again, we're trying to use our arms. There's four. There's our halfway five. Last one. And 10. Go right to the wall here. Kind of move these chairs out of the way. All right, so we're gonna start with our right leg up. Nice 45 degree angle. Start up on your toes. And in 3, 2, 1, here we go. 10 seconds hard. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And rest, take a breath. Great work there. We're gonna take about 45 seconds to a minute here. Let that heart rate come down a little bit. Catch your breath. Go through that a couple more times. All right, now that we've taken a nice 45 to 60 second break, we're gonna run through that same thing again. Foot up on the chair, on the step, whatever you're using. Take a nice step out, and up we go. There's 7, try a couple more. And there's 10, switch it. Find the chair. We'll hop out. Up with that arm. Try to keep that nice balance, nice tall posture. There's our halfway five. Last one. And 10. Back to the wall we go. Same thing. Nice 45 degree angle. We're going to start with our left leg up this time. We just did our right. So start with your left leg up, up on that toe. And 3, 2, 1, here we go and drive. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest, take 45 to 60 seconds. Try it 2 more times, take a breather. All right, guys, good work here. We're halfway through. We're gonna try this two more times. Same thing going through. We're gonna do that split-legged squat drop right to the wall. Find the chair, little hop out. Pump that arm. Nice deep squat, four to go. Last one, and 10, shake it off. Find the chair, find the step, whatever you're using. Little hop out, same thing. Nice tall posture, here we go. Halfway five. Last one, and 10, rest, shake that off to the wall. We're gonna start with our right leg elevated, up on our toes, nice deep breath. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Touch those toes and drive. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest, one more time. Take a nice deep breath here. 45 seconds to breathe. Come back for our last one. All right, everybody, we're gonna start our last set right now. This is where it really counts. We're really working on that muscle memory. Make sure we're getting nice and deep on that squat. Pump those arms, touch those toes as quickly as we can over on the wall once we get there. Last 10 each leg on the split squats here. Go down, pump that arm. Try to stay nice and tall. Try not to hunch over. We don't wanna squat like this. Nice and tall. 6. Last one, 10, shake that off. Left leg will go up and elevated. Hop up, here we go, last 10. Four to go. Last one, 10, rest to the wall, last time. Start with our left leg up, on our toes here. Nice deep breath, and 3, 2, 1, hit it and go hard. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, rest, good work everybody. So that's our first set down. We're gonna come back after about a 45, 60 second break with a little bit of hip work and a little bit of form running. So go ahead, take a quick drink. We'll be right back with that next drill. All right, everybody, now that we're kind of done with our speed and agility work, our next two drills are gonna be a little bit of form running, and we're gonna work on some hip strength mobility, that sort of thing. They'll really help us kind of through our hips. So I have just kind of a weighted straight bar here. This weighs a couple of pounds. You don't need anything too crazy. You know, like your Olympic barbells, that sort of thing, weigh 45 pounds. That's gonna be way too heavy for this next drill. So if you're a baseball player with a baseball bat, if you have an electric cross stick, field hockey stick, anything that you might be able to hold, even if you're a volleyball player holding a volleyball up over your head, anything that you're just gonna add a little bit of weight. So our first drill, this is gonna go up overhead, whatever you're kind of holding. above our head. We're gonna start with our right leg up. Then we're just gonna kind of do a 1-2 as quick as we can down to the floor. So again, foot's dorsiflexed, up towards the ground. Don't get sloppy, don't point it down. Up, and 1-2, and back. 1-2, back. We'll try about 8 or so of those. And then we're gonna go right to our hip work. We're gonna kind of do some speed skaters. So we're gonna start one leg behind us. You're gonna use our arms to kind of drive up off the floor, drive up and out. We're gonna try about 10 of those total, so it'll be about 5 each leg. Then we'll take that same 45 seconds of rest. So go ahead, grab whatever you're gonna hold up overhead. This needs to go straight up overhead. So I'm here, don't get it too far out. Gonna go straight up. We're gonna start with our right leg. We're gonna go 1-2, drive. 1-2, good. 1-2. There's 5, 6, 2 to go. Last one. Good, set that down. Make sure it's out of the way so we're not gonna trip over it. Now we're gonna do our speed skaters. We're gonna do about 5 each way, so 10 in total. We're gonna start. 1, 2, gather, drive. There's our 5, halfway. 2 to go. Last one, and 10. Good work, same thing. Take 45 seconds, take a little breather, grab a drink. Be right back for those other legs. All right, everybody, good break there. Now we're gonna go with our left leg elevated. So same thing, our weighted bar, our volleyball, whatever we have is gonna go up overhead. We're gonna start with our left leg up this time and going for 8. Again, dorsiflex that foot, here we go. 1, 2, 1. Gather your balance, 2. There's 3, 4. 2 to go. Last one. Good, take a breather, rest. Right into our speed skaters. Set that down out of the way. Same thing, going for 10. Really make sure we're driving as far as we can, side to side. Gather your balance, drive up with those arms. There's our halfway 5. Last one, 10. Take a breath, 45 seconds, grab a quick drink. 2 to go. All right, everybody, good break there. Gonna start with our right leg elevated this time. We're about halfway done. We're gonna keep on moving through this, we're almost done. Bar nice and high, volleyball nice and high up overhead. Right leg up, and here we go with our 1-2s. 1-2, drive, 1. There's 5, 2 to go. Good, last one. Right, set it down, set it out of the way. Back to our speed skaters. One leg behind, drive out to the side. Halfway. 2 to go. Last one. 10. Nice work, everybody. Take a break. We're going to come back for our last set. Grab a quick drink of water. 45 seconds. All right, everybody, nice rest there. We're gonna try one more time. This is, again, where it really counts. So make sure we're really making, focusing well on driving up with our feet, keeping our feet dorsiflexed. Don't get sloppy footwork now when we're a little bit tired. So we're gonna go bar up overhead, elevate that left leg, dorsiflex that foot, and here we go, one, two. There's five. Last one. Nice work, set that down. We're done with the bar. Last time for speed skaters. One leg starts behind. Use those arms, drive up off the floor. Here we go, last ones. Gather, drive. There's our halfway. Push yourself through these last five. Catch your bounce if you need to. Last one, 10. Take a breather. We're gonna come back with a little drill, and then we're all done. Nice work, everybody. Take 45 seconds, take a breath. All right, everybody, nice work so far. We're gonna end today with just one little drill. As you can see, I have two basketballs kind of on my left and my right-hand side. Don't need to be basketballs necessarily. They can be tennis balls, they can be paper plates, solo cups, whatever you have, just to kind of set on the ground that are about a couple of feet apart from you. The next and last drill that we're gonna do is called an arrow drill. It's called that just because we might need a helper, brother, sister, mom or dad for this last drill. We're gonna just have four directions that you can point, kind of somebody off camera. So it's gonna be up, so you're gonna jump, down, we're gonna hit floor, come back up, and obviously either side will shuffle out, touch that basketball, come back. So the whole time, the goal of this exercise, we're gonna stay nice and tall, we're gonna keep our feet moving. So we're gonna keep our feet moving, and when somebody points, we're gonna go whatever direction they're pointing. So I'll just kind of run through this really quick with each direction, just so you can kind of get the gist of it. I would do this a couple times through, 20 to 30 seconds each. If you have a brother or sister, you wanna swap out, feel free to do that. We'll go for about, we'll go each direction, just so that you guys kind of get the gist of what's going on, and then we'll go from there. So we'll start right in the middle of those basketballs. Again, they're a couple feet up from me. We're gonna get down to a nice athletic stance. We're gonna start moving our feet up, back down, move our feet down. Back up as quick as we can. We're gonna go over to my left, touch, back, move those feet. Now we're gonna go the other direction, down, touch, and back. So that's the gist of that drill, 20 to 30 seconds. Whoever's kind of up in front, just pointing, making sure they're going through each of those directions. You can do that a couple times through, three or four times, 20 or 30 seconds. And that's a nice little speed and agility work, mostly body weight that you can do at home. So that's the gist of kind of our sports performance training today. If this is something that you like, this is one of my passions. So feel free to leave us a like or a comment. Let us know that you want to see more of this. We can kind of come back next week with a little bit more speed and agility work that we can do outside when the weather gets a little bit nicer, even in a basement. Thanks for everybody to watch, and we'll see you next time.